Hello everybody, Fernando Nunes here. In this video, I'll be showing you something a little bit different from the things that I usually show here. Today, I'll be showing you how I drew Rick Sanchez using some tools that I'm not used to use from Adobe Illustrator, especially the Mesh tool. The very first step is to get a reference image and vectorize it using the Pen tool, Basic Shapes and Pathfinder options. I needed to redraw each part of the image, just like a common vector process, which is exactly the same way that I will have to think when adding meshes to the shapes. Each part of the reference needs to be thought separately, because you have to keep in mind that the drawing world is pretty much a construction game. After redrawing it, I added some few colors, mixing my visual identity with the character's appearance, and duplicated the artboard to preserve our main shapes, because the shapes will get very limited to be added once a mesh is applied on it. In this new duplicated layer, I start to add mesh on it. And this is a super powerful tool that plays with axis lines and color mixing that can make your vector illustrations look more 3D or photorealistic. It works by adding a mesh over a closed shape and add another color to this new mesh. It's good to have an experience of basic shading on drawing and know where you have to put some shading, but not too much, because Illustrator will do this for you. It doesn't matter which shape you are going to use on your drawing, Illustrator will suggest some axes on it. It will draw axes in the best way to represent your shape in 3D. It will add volume onto your shape. It is important to say that they only look like 3D, but they actually are not. I mix it with some other effects like gradient and blur, but in general, I want to show the power of the mesh too. Well, the file is available to download in the video description. Make sure you are subscribed to my channel and let's enjoy the process.
Radio.